from really back. I know his dad taught me, and he knows Yi as well. Yeah, so both, so we saw each other across the barricades, and then we sort of signaled each other and we moved across. And then we had a good discussion. We said we wanted to keep this a clean fight, and he totally agreed with that. And he said we want to focus on the issues, and we totally agreed with that too. So we talked about the upgrading and the improvement programs, and I pointed out that, you know, these funding mechanisms are very complex. It's almost like healthcare, where you've got MediSave, MediShield, MediFund, CHESS Orange, CHESS Blue, Pioneer Generation, and so many different schemes. So it's hard for people to get things sorted out. And then he said he was going to try to give clarity to that, and I agreed with that too. So we want to make it clear what is URA, what is HDB, what is Town Council, and then we can engage on the issues.
Do you think STEP was nonpartisan?
I'm pretty sure they're nonpartisan. I mean, we've dealt with them on so many different occasions. There may be certain individuals who have their own prejudices either way, but by and large, the civil service is very professional. Singapore has a very highly rated professional civil service, and they are nonpartisan.
If and when Dr. Xi's elected, what difference will he bring to Bukit Batok?
Oh, it'll make a huge difference. For one thing, Bukit Batok then will be hyped up as a single-member town council, and this will actually be a chance for the residents to have a model town, you know, where we can actually put into practice many things in the SDP town council plan, where residents can have a say in what goes on, and where we'll be directly managing the town council. Thank you.
Dr. Okay. Tan, what do you think are the election issues at play at this by-election?
Well, there are many. We have focused on the local issues because these are issues which are important to the residents of Bukit Batok. But just like people everywhere in Singapore, they're worried about healthcare, they're worried about cost of living, they're worried about looking after the cost of looking after elderly relatives, they're worried about childcare, they're worried about education. You know, there's so many tweaks that are being made to the education system that it's very hard for kids to keep up with what's important. And you know, like the PSLE thing, the Ministry of Education has admitted that they don't know how schools are going to select students if they've done away with the T-scores. So these are clearly issues which need to be debated, and these are things which the residents have concerns about.
So what's the strategy of SDP coming into this by-election?
Well, again, as you heard from Dr. Chi, we're working very hard. We've been trying to connect with the voters. We're telling them about our policies, and we have social programs that we have in mind. We also have a town council transition plan. And we're going to make sure that if and when Dr. Chi is elected, the transition will be very smooth. So we've got accountants, we've got lawyers, we've got volunteers who are actually coming in to ensure that everything goes on smoothly, that the residents can continue to enjoy quality of life that they've had, and that Bukit Batok will become an even better town for them.